For those of us that we're working in sketching pencils.
Can I ask you about your pencil?
Pardon?
Can I ask you about your pencil? Is that did you buy that as a complete set?
I can't hear you, May.
Oh, did you buy that as a complete set? The pencil?
Yeah, most of it is one set. Uh-huh. So most of the blue pencils, this comes in one set. I can show you.
Which brand is this?
This is the Mars brand. I don't know if I have the
lid. Oh, the Mars, the Staedtler?
Yeah.
Staedtler Mars Lumograph, I think.
These pencils are very good, but you don't need the big set because it comes with a lot of pencils I never use, like F.
Uh-huh.
Like the ones, I think, for these ones, the one that I use, probably you only need three of them, and you can make a good sketch.
So the three would be HB?
Let me think about it. Uh-huh. Let me think about the ones I actually use.
Uh-huh. Okay.
HB, actually, you never have to buy because all the office pencils that we buy are all HB.
Yeah, but when I look at the pencil sets for drawing, it always comes with the HB.
Yeah, but you actually...
2H and 4H, I don't know if we will ever use those.
No, I never use those. They're so light. It's like drafting, right?
Okay.
You can't really see it.
Okay.
I think the only ones you would ever buy is probably in the Bs. So your 2B or your 4B, 6B, those ones.
Yeah, I think 2B to 6B will be the common, right?
Yeah, but you don't even need them all. You just need like 2B and 3B. There's not going to be much of a difference.
Hmm. Okay.
2B, 4B, 6B.
Actually it goes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's what I've seen.
Yeah. But if you're buying, I think you can buy the bulk, right?
I'm not sure.
I'm thinking you can buy these separate and bulk. You can buy like just 2B, but like 20 of them.
Yeah, correct.
But actually that's a good idea. Okay, so we can get started. Does anyone still need this? Oops. Speak now or I'm going to take it away.
Yes, I need 1 second.
Okay. Turn the light off. We'll give it another minute or two for people who are coming in.
But that's okay. I don't know where it's my phone.
I'm looking for my...
I can use my iPad to do it. Okay.
Uh-huh. Very good. Okay. Yeah. So today we're working on fabric and how to make the fabric. The cherries are kind of like a side note. Okay. So... the first thing that we will do is actually sketch in our cherries. So we'll make the forms and then mark in some of the fabric lines. Oh, somebody just came in. We'll just leave it up for another minute. Annie, Okay, let's begin with our sketch. So I am going to be using, I think, 2B, this one. And I will be sketching out, this page is 30, let's flip the page. So we'll be using the 2B to create the cherries and the fabric. So just in the middle here, you can make it as big or as small as you want. I would suggest making it bigger. And if it's easier, you can draw a big circle and then go in after to make it look like a cherry. So the cherry is like a heart shape. It's almost like a heart shape or like a very big kidney bean. And while you're doing that, you can mark out the highlight here. So there's a highlight right here. Over here. No, make them closer together. And then I will mark out the highlight here. And then we can create the stems. Mm-hmm. And then we can work on the fabric. So you can create the folds of the fabric just to sketch it out with lines. There's one right here. Just to see the fabric as another object. So wherever you see lines in the fabric, you will put it down on your page. So you can make a mental note of where the shadows and the highlights are. For example, if you know that this right here, this section right here is a shadow, you can either begin to mark it out or just make a mental note of where the dark areas are. Like right here, you have a shadow, you can draw it in. You have a shadow behind the cherry. So you can draw that in. And you have a shadow over here behind this cherry. Okay, so let's begin with our shading. I'm going to switch to a darker pencil to make it a little bit easier. You can use 6B, oops, or 5B, any of your dark pencils. And the first thing we'll be doing is filling in these shadowed areas. So using your pencil, you will start filling in these areas. Use long strokes. Thank you. See, right here, it's darker, so I will make it darker there. Here. And then on the side here where the cherry is, a little bit darker. So the cherry on the side is darker on over here than the shadow. So you want to make it quite dark. It's the darkest thing on the page. And try to leave this highlight part white. It's a lot easier to leave it white than go back in and have to either erase it or add more white. Got a little bit ahead of myself here. Actually, you're supposed to do each area. So do some here, do some there so that you can see the contrast, but I just did all of this in one go. So we'll start doing some of the fabric. So what you want to do for the fabric is figure out where the darkest areas are in the fabric. And you're going to start filling them in like they're any other object. So don't look at it as a fabric, just look at it as little objects that you need to fill in. And just note where the highlights are. This is really important. There are highlights that you can draw out. So this in the middle here, this is a highlight and I want to leave it alone. Thank you. So right now I'm trying to go in one direction, but later I'll go back and cross hatch it. I think I need a bigger pencil. There we go. There's a big shadow over here. And then we can also work on this cherry here. So while we're working over here, so again, start with the darkest areas, like the side. And the shadow. So I'm drawing a really dark line along the outline of the side. And then we can start continuing to fill in the fabric. So fabric is about very slowly filling in each section. It's kind of like a test of patience. You have to be very patient. Thank you. gonna keep going with that. I think the fabric is easier to handle if you can see it as a pattern instead of instead of one big object. So like many little objects, it's a pattern. So right now I'm going in again to make some areas darker, but I'm just using straight lines. And then for those remaining white spaces, you can go in side to side like this. So let's begin to fill this area out. So I need my white highlight. And then the rest of this inside is pretty much the same. Just making this shadow a little bit bigger. Hello. If you're starting to lose track of what is happening here, you can take a step back and look at it from far away. That's usually very helpful. Remember, try to make the stem a little bit dark so that you can see it. And there is a shadow, but we'll add it in later. I should have started at this side so that my hand doesn't look like this. But that is okay. So if you're right-handed, it usually helps to start from the other side so that you don't have this happening to you. You can also take a paper towel and put it under so your hand doesn't smudge the pencil. And then all of this is pretty much the same shade. So I just want to fill it in. So you just want to go ahead and fill all of this in. And then now you can clearly see, right? It's easier to see where we need to add in more shadow and where we need to make it lighter. We can see now that side is covered. So you would just keep going, just know where the highlights are and go around the highlights. You can always make it darker afterwards. And I like to use my darkest pencil because I can just press lighter and it's just less effort. So this patch right here behind the cherry is quite dark. And so is this line here. There's really no wrong way to go about doing the fabric. As long as you try to get in the dark areas, then you are golden. And you can experiment with using the side of your pencil. Basically, you just want to fill in space, and then it's easier to see where you need to add more and where you need to add less. So I'm going in between this highlight here. I'm trying to fill this in quite quickly on this side. Okay, so now it's a bit easier for us to see where everything is. Oh, and we do need to add this shadow here behind the cherry stem. So you can just sketch it in. Because it's a shadow, it's quite blurry. And then we'll just wait a minute for everybody to keep filling this in. And then we will make the dark areas darker and the lighter areas lighter. So we still have quite a bit of time. This is so bright. Okay, so I'm just going to keep going slowly. But this time, instead of going in this direction, I'm going in the opposite direction with my shading. I'm gonna put something under my hand. And the reason I'm doing that is so I can create those interesting cross-hatching marks. So I'll start in this corner this time. So this is kind of about layering and taking your time. You need some of it white because the highlights are there, right? And if you want to bring the highlights back a bit, you can use your eraser. I'm just going in and layering. So I still have this section to do. And know that this part right here, there's a highlight. So I'm gonna bring it out with my eraser. Okay, almost done. So again, keep going on the fabric. And you can use your eraser to bring out certain areas, for example, right here. Again, if it gets confusing, then take a step back and look at it from a different perspective. And right now, I'm trying to soften some of these lines because I feel like they are a little bit harsh. Okay, this one, I think it's almost done. If you feel like some of the areas are too bright, you can go back in and make them less bright. Some of them are a little bit dark. Excuse me. Okay, I think this one is done for today. Mm-hmm. And I know people are hard at work, but if you want to show your work so far, that would be awesome. Let's see, everybody. I will look at it from my tiny screen.
Yes, it does.
Oh, very nice, Ying. Yafa, Jerry. Good job, everybody. It looks so awesome. Xiaorong.
Thank you.